continue to do this for Pastor and Sister Hill. The court says to Pastors James and Marilyn Hill, thanks for the 36 years of ministry over this church. A special thanks to the both of you for the teaching that you gave to me, Sammy, and his family. Your teaching has made us the Christians that we are today. With love, Vanita Stevens, Sammy, Lakendo, Samaria, Lakenya, and Sammy, thank you.
This morning's announcements, that'll be Sister Hill, okay? Let's say amen for Sister Hill. Amen. She's going to join us at the studio on the events and conferences, beautiful homes at Christian Center, scheduling, and so forth. Let's say amen, Sister Hill.
Thank you, Sister Lania. That was so unexpected. It's beautiful, and thank you so much. You know, sometimes you plant seeds, and you never know. Sometimes they come up, and again, our Sister Lenita, we go way back, and there have been times when I didn't quite know where she was, but we knew where, I knew where she lived, and I just really appreciate that so much. Over the years, we maintained contact, and those words, what a beautiful Mother's Day gift. Thank you so much. Well, are you blessed this morning? I'm trying to catch my breath over there. Glory to God. Isn't this a beautiful day? A special day. It is Mother's Day. How many mothers do we have in the house? Amen. Let me see your hands. Well, actually, let's do better than that. I want you to stand if you can. If you can. If you can, I want you to stand. Thank you.
back to Sister Pearl. Raise your hand, please.
Sister Deborah, but this time I drew a blank and I don't have anything sophisticated, but I do have something, and I think I want to dedicate this to the young mothers who still have children in the home. That's for Amber over there. Hi Amber, glad to see you. We didn't recognize the visitors, forgot to do that. And we have a special visitor in the house this morning that you'll be hearing from a little bit later on. This is especially for the young mothers who sometimes feel like throwing up their hands. Now, somebody said yes. This is for you. The young mothers as well as the young fathers. I've been there and I've done that. I've been a mother for 45 years, and they're all grown and gone, y'all. But I really still love my children. And I know that all of you that have children that are grown and gone, you still love them as well. So this is just a little something that someone sent me. And if you've heard it before, just listen again. Because, as I said, this is dedicated to the young mothers and the young fathers. Fathers, I want you to listen up. Well, let me dedicate it to the older fathers as well. Maybe you missed out on something, and if you did, you can share it with your children, and you can be maybe just a little bit different grandparent. Are you ready? This is why I love Mom. Why I love Mom. Mom and Dad were watching TV when Mom said, "I'm tired, and it's getting late. I think I'll go to bed." She went to the kitchen to make sandwiches for the next day's lunch, rinsed out the popcorn bowls, took meat out of the freezer for supper the following evening, checked the cereal box levels, filled the sugar container, put spoons and bowls on the table, and started the coffee pot brewing for the next morning. She then put some wet clothes in the dryer, put a load of clothes in the washer, ironed a shirt, and secured a loose button. She picked up the game pieces left on the table, put the phone back on the charger, and put the phone book in the dresser drawer. She watered the plants, emptied a waste basket, and hung a towel to dry. She yawned and stretched and headed for the bedroom. She stopped by the desk
and wrote a note to the teacher, counted out some cash for the field trip, and pulled a textbook out from hiding under the chair. She signed a birthday card for a friend, addressed and stamped the envelope, and wrote a quick note for the grocery store. She put both near her purse. Mom then washed her face with a 3-in-1 cleanser, put on her night solution, an age-fighting moisturizer, brushed and flossed her teeth, and filed her nails. Dad called out, "I thought you were going to bed." "I'm on my way," she said. She put some water into the dog's dish and brought the cat inside, then made sure the doors were locked and the patio light was on. She looked in on each one of the kids and turned out their bedside lamps and the TV, hung up a shirt, threw some dirty socks into the hamper, and had a brief conversation with the one still up doing homework. In her own room, she set the alarm, laid out clothing for the next day, straightened up the shoe rack. She added 3 things to her 6 most important things to do list. She said her prayers and visualized the accomplishments of her goals. About that time, Dad turned off the TV and announced to no one in particular, "I'm going to bed." And without another thought, he went to bed. Anything extraordinary here? Wonder why women live longer? Because we are made for the long haul. And we can't die sooner because we still have things to do. Amen. Praise God. God bless you. That's for the young women and for the young men, that if you're not helping with that long list of stuff I read off, that means that you get busy, young men. And for those of you that the children are going out of the home, your grandparents teach the younger ones. Amen.